welcome to the students of e-Pathshala. We were doing Shloka 17 of the 5th canto of Kalidasa's Kumara Sambhavam. We will continue with the same. I will write the text of the verse. Virodhi sattojjhita purva matsaram द्रुमैर अभीष्ट प्रसवार्चितातिथि नवोटजाभ्यंतर संभृतानलम् तपोवनम तच्च बभूव पावनम. इन दिस वर्स कालिदास इज शोइंग हाउ द तपोवन बिकेम सेक्रेड. पावनम इज सेक्रेड. So the tapovana or the penance grove, tatu tapovanam pavanam babhuva, it became sacred. How it became sacred is explained in the first three quarters of the verse. The animals which have a natural animosity, so sattva stands for animal, virodhi is inimical or having a natural enmity, so virodhi sattva ujjhita means they quit their earlier animosity, the mutual irritation of the animals which are naturally inimical and ill disposed towards each other, that animosity was shed by the animals. And secondly, the trees, they honored the guests by an offer of whatever they desired. And thirdly, the fire that was kindled there in the interior of the new hermitages, that blazed well. So by these indications, as a consequence of these actions, the penance grove became sacred, says Kalidasa. We have just explained the first quarter of the verse. Virodhi sattva jhita purva matsaram. Creatures which are ill disposed towards each other naturally now shed their earlier enmity and have become friendly towards each other. The word sattva has several senses in Sanskrit. So, dravyasu vyavasayeshu sattvam astri cha jantushu. So, when it refers to a creature, so it is not strilinga. It can be either pullinga or navumsakalinga. So, you can have either sattvaha or sattvam. And matsara is their mutual irritation. मत्सरो न्यशुभद्वेषे तद्वत् कृपणयो स्त्रिषु, says Amarakosha. The idea given in this verse has its parallel in Raghuvamsha, Anigrahatrasa Vinita Sattvam. So, the sattvas or animals there have become tame. This idea is conveyed there also in that verse. So, we have seen the Vigrahavakya of this Virodhinascha. Te sattvascha. Sattva is masculine here. Yields virodhi sattvaha. Taihi ujjhitaha. Purva matsaraha. Yasmin. We have to add tat. Because this refers to the word tapovanam. Therefore, tat tapovanam, because tapovan itself is in 1-1, Navumsakalinga Prathama Vyakti Ekvachana. So, the whole adjectival expression, rodhisattva jhita purva matsaram, is also Navumsakalinga Prathama Vyakti Ekvachana. The second reason for the tapovana becoming sacred is Drumairabhishta prasavarchita tithi. As the tapas of Parvati progressed, there were many who came there as guests. In an earlier verse, we have seen many sages visiting the tapovana. So, there are many guests here, and whatever they desired, they were offered by the very trees themselves. So, it is as though there was no need for Parvati to render hospitality to them, but the task was taken up by the very trees themselves. So, Druma is tree, Drumaihi, so it is M33. Abhishta prasavarchita tithi. The Vigrahavakya for this would be Abhishtascha te prasavascha. This yields Abhishta prasavaha. Taihi, that is Abhishta prasavaihi, architaha, atithayaha. Once again, as in this case, we have yasmin tat. In order to refer to the tapovana. So, yasmin tadu tapovanam. Abhishta is whatever is desired, and prasava is the offer or the yield of the trees, the yield given by the trees. And this way, the trees themselves worshipped the guests. The maxim of Atithi Devo Bhava is practiced here not only by human beings, it is by even the very trees themselves. Therefore, the Drumas are offering the Atithis whatever their Abhishta was. Such was the kind of hospitality that was given by the trees. So, even in Kalidasa Abhijnana Shakuntala, we have in the fourth act a situation where the trees themselves make the offerings of various ornaments, etc., at the moment of the departure of Shakuntala. So, all this is also an indication of the growth of tapas and the sanctity of the tapovana, as a consequence of which, even the trees themselves would offer whatever fruits or flowers the atithis or the guests would have, you see, a desire for in their mind. And thirdly, Navotajabhyantara Sambhritanalam. The fires there in the hermitage, in the interior of the hermitage. So, Utaja is the same as a Parnashala, so it is the cottage. The new cottages, the Amarakosha reads, पर्णशाला पर्णशाला रोटजो स्त्रियां सो दि फ्रेश कॉटेजेस इनसाइड देम वर दि फायर्स अभ्यंतरम त्वंतरालम से समरकोशा अभ्यंतरा एंड अंतराल आर सिनोनिमस संभृतानलम दि फायर्स देर दे ब्लेज्ड वेरी वेल संभृता वेल ब्लेजिंग विच इटसेल्फ इज आल्सो ए मार्क ऑफ दि प्रोग्रेस ऑफ तपस the dissolution for navataja abhyantara samvrtanalam would be navanicha tani utajani this yields navatajani tesham that is navatajanam अभ्यंतराणि क्यूस नवोटजाभ्यंतराणि तेषु संभृतम् अनलम् संभृताः अनलाः बिकॉज अनल इज मैस्कुलाइन वंस अगेन As in the case of these two, Yasmin Tatu. In Sanskrit, the word Anila refers to the wind and Anala refers to the fire. So, Krishanu Pavako Analaha, say Samarakosha. So, Anala, both Anala and Anila are masculine. So, Sambhrataha Analaha Yasmin Tatu. Once again, adjectival to Tapovanam. So, these adjectives are so placed as to indicate the reason for the tapovana becoming sacred. So the sanctity of the tapovana is indicated by all these factors. So with the progress of tapas, these are the effects that are possible is what is indicated here. So in this verse, there are three things that is indicated. One is how the animals were content. So it is not by one attacking the other that the animals were content. So shedding that also they were content. This is one indication. And second quarter indicates manushya tripti. So the first indicates prani tripti and second indicates manushya tripti, how humans were satisfied. And third one refers to devata tripti. So how the divinities were satisfied with the progress here, so they were appeased properly, and therefore the three things that are indicated are the practice of ahimsa, the practice of atithisatkara, and the practice of agni paricharya. These three have been indicated in these three. The word prasava has its synonyms given in Amarakosha: syadutpade phale pushpe prasavo garbhamochane. So the word prasava has can indicate either fruits or flowers, so as the case may be. So depending upon the desire of the guests, either fruits or flowers were shed by the trees there. So these are all marks of the progress of tapas as indicated by the Yoga Sutra, Ahimsa Pratishthayam Tatsannidhau Vairatyagaha. So depending upon the various pratishthas, the various kinds of establishments that happen in the course of the tapas, the various siddhis are indicated in Patanjali's Yoga Sutra itself. You can pass on to the next verse. Shloka number 18. The text is like this. Yada phalam पूर्वतपस्समाधिना नतावता लभ्यमं स्तकांक्षितं तदा अनपेक्ष्य स्वशरीरमार्दवं तपो महत् सा चरितुं प्रचक्रमे। सा इज द सब्जेक्ट ऑफ द सेंटेंस, रेफर्स टू पार्वती। सा प्रचक्रमे she began महत् तपः चरितुम्। चरितुम् इज द परफॉर्मेंस, सो शी बिगैन टू परफॉर्म। चरितुम् प्रचक्रमे, सो शी बिगैन टू परफॉर्म महत् तपः, ए ग्रेट ऑस्टेरिटी। She began to perform a severe austerity. Tada, then. When is indicated by yada in the first quarter of the verse. Yada phalam purva tapas samadhina natavata labhyam amamsta kankshitam. When she felt, amamsta is she felt. When she felt that her kankshitam, her desire was labhyam, attainable. By tavata puratapas samadhina, when the kankshitam phalam, the fruit that was desired, kankshitam is desired, so the desired fruit was labhyam, attainable, na labhyam, not attainable. When she began to feel that what she wanted to attain was not attainable by her previous purva, tapas samadhi is concentration. So when she began to feel that the kind of concentration, the degree of concentration, in Sanskrit tavata means of that quantity. So tavata, by means of that measure of her concentration that was practiced so far, when she found that the fruit that she desired was not attainable, then she began to perform a more severe austerity. Mahat tapaha charitum sa prachakrame. Now, the difference was that she began to do that disregarding anapekshya, the delicacy, mardavam, of her own frame, swasharira. So ignoring the delicacy of her own body, she now began to perform a more severe tapas. The previous shlokas have indicated that Parvates were performing good tapas, and there were good indications that her tapas was progressing very well. So the various sages themselves had come to visit Parvati's penance grove, and that itself was a sure indication of the good progress of Parvati. However, in spite of the fact that there were good indications and There are also the visits of some of the best of the sages to her parents' grove to pay compliment to her or to learn things from her and so on. Yet Parvati, she was herself not satisfied with the progress of her tapas, and that is because when an action does not yield the benefit that was intended to be achieved by that action, that such an action would not impart any satisfaction, and therefore dissatisfied with her previous tapas, Parvati now began to step up her the performance of her tapas. This is what is indicated in the shloka. So kankshitam phalam na labhyam amamsta, when she felt that the earlier way she was doing the tapas was not quite satisfactory, so it was then that she thought that she must improve her tapas. The anvaya of the shloka is this: kankshitam phalam tavata purva tapasamadhina labhyam yada sa na amamsta tada swasharira mardavam anapekshya mahat tapaha charitum sa prachakrame. So she began to perform tapas. The word prachakrame is from pra plus root krama, for which it is lit prathama purusha ekavachana. So this is from the root kramu pada vikshepe, as given in the dhatu patha of Panini. Kramu is to step, and with pra it means to commence. The forms of root kramu, so this is 1a, that is bhuvadi and atmanepada. The forms are kramate, kramete, kramante, kramase, kramethe, kramadhve, krame, kramavahe, kramamahe in latlakara. Here it is in litlakara. We have the forms are, see, pra plus chakrame, chakramate, chakramire, chakramishe, chakramathe, chakramidhve, chakrame, chakramivahe, chakramimahe. These are the forms. We also have another root krama in the fourth conjugation, where you have, it is 4p, kramyati, etc. Kramyati, kramyataha, kramyanti, etc. The meaning is the same. So here we have the prathama gana dhatu. Sa tapaha charitum prachakrame. Charitum itself is from root charu, for which we have the addition of tumun, or the infinitive of purpose, as it is called. So the root is, according to Dhatu Bhata, chara gati bhakshana yoho. The two senses are gatyartha and bhakshanartha. So here it is the former sense, gatyartha here. Mahat tapaha. Tapaha is N21 here. So because it is the object of prachakrame, and as a consequence, its adjective is also N21. So mahat tapaha charitum sa prachakrame. So she began to perform a great austerity. So mahat here stands for mahattara. So the tapas that she was performing was already mahat, and now she began to increase the intensity of her tapas, and that has been described in the verses that follow. And the word tapaha is to be, this is a, the base of this word is tapas sakaranta napumsakalinga, and it is declined as tapaha tapasi tapamsi, tapaha tapasi tapamsi, etc. And here it is in the Dvitiya Vibhakti Ekvachana form. Mahat tapaha sa charitum prachakrame. So she began to perform greater austerities. Now tada, she began to perform it then, Malinatha says, tada is to be taken as avilambena, so without delay. The moment she realized that what she was doing, though it led to very many other fruits and effects and benefits and indications, the moment she realized that this was not going to serve her purpose, namely the attainment of Shiva as her Lord, the moment she realized that, she began to take up an intenser tapas. And this she began to do totally ignoring the tenderness of her own frame. Mardavam is from Mrudoho Bhavaha. The Bhavartha is conveyed by either the addition of Tva as in Mrudutva or Ta as in Mrudutta, or by the Tadita form. These two are also Tadita forms. This Tadita form without an added and visible suffix, and therefore it is Mardavam. Mrudoho Bhavaha is Mardam, Mardavam. Therefore there are three forms for the Bhavartha here. So Mrudoho Bhavaha Mardavam Swasya Shariram yields Swashariram. And Swasharirasya Mardavam, Swasharira Mardavam. And as this word is also an object of anapeksha, this word itself is to be taken as being in Dvitiya Vibhakti, and therefore this is N21. So Swasharira Mardavam anapeksha, disregarding, ignoring, so totally relegating to the background the delicacy of her body, so she began to perform a severer penance. When was this done? When she felt, so amamsta, when she began to realize that, so this is from root manu. And this is in the Lung Lakara. Narratives in Sanskrit generally abound in Lung and Lit forms. The forms of this this dhatu in this lakara are amamsta amamsatam amamsata amamsthaha amamsatham amangdvam amamsi amamswahi amamsmahi. These are the forms in the Lung Lakara. So when she began to feel, when she realized that the fruit that she desired, kankshitam, itself is from root kanksh. The Panini Dhatapatha is kakshi kankshayam. So this qualifies phalam. Phalam is Navumsakalinga, and then phalam, labhyam. So we can take it as either Dvitiya Vibhakti or Prathama Vibhakti, either N1 or N21, either way it can be taken. Phalam labhyam also is N21 here, better to take it as N21. Tavata means that amount of, that measure of the dissolution for this is tat pramanam asya. Is equal to tavan. The words yavan, etavan, etc. are also similarly derived. So this is the Tritiya Vibhakti Ekavachana form. As the word samadhi is masculine, This is also M31, both are M31. The resolution for Purvata Samadhina is Purvascha Asau Tapas Samadhischa. Is Pura Tapas Samadhi. The word Tapas Samadhi itself can be taken as dissolved as Tapasaha Samadhi. So, Tena Yada Phalam Pura Tapas Samadhina Natavata Labhyam Amamsta Kankshitam. The word Labhyam is to be analyzed as Labdhum Yogyam Labhyam. Natavata Labhyam Ahamsta Kankshitam Tadana Pekshya Swasharira Mardavam Tapo Mahatsa Charitum Prachakrame. So there is a clear indication that Parvati had that clarity of mind as to what her goal was and what she was achieving now, and therefore she upgraded her tapas, is what is mentioned in this verse. We shall pass on to the next verse. Verse number 19. Klamam yayau Kanduka Lila Yapiya Taya Muninam Charitam Vyagahyata Dhruvam Vupuhu Kanchana Padma Nirmitam Mrudu Prakrityacha Sasara Mevacha. From this shloka onwards, Kalidasa describes the kind of a severe austerity that Parvati resorted to in order to attain her great goal. And as an indication of the kind of rigor that her body withstood, he shows in this verse how she was paradoxically both delicate by nature and strong. The delicacy of Parvati's frame is indicated in the first line of the verse, because Parvati used to get tired. Klamam yayau is getting tired. Klamam yayau, by the Kanduka Leela or the game of ball. So playing with the ball, that itself would make her feel tired, and such Parvati now took to a very different lifestyle. So, Ya refers to Parvati, Taya also refers to Parvati. So, the self-same person who used to be tired by mere play with the ball, that very person now began to adopt a rigorous lifestyle, that identity is shown by the two pronouns ya and taya. So the very same person, ya, taya, by her very self, this was done. So what was done by her? Now she vyagahyata, this is in passive voice. So while the first quarter is in active voice, the second quarter is in passive voice. Taya, by her, the conduct, charitam, of the sages was vyagahyata, means dived into. She delved deep into the conduct of the sages. So what the greatest of sages would do, such a conduct she took upon herself. So the very same Parvati who used to be very easily tired by a mere game with the ball, now began to compete, as it were, with the best of sages. Their very conduct she began to assume. She delved deeper into the lifestyle of the sages. As the first quarter indicates her extreme delicacy and the second quarter indicates extreme hardness of her frame, Kalidasa brings this out with an analogy, how a thing could be simultaneously delicate and strong. Dhruvam, surely. So this indicates his surmise, so as to what must have been the case here. Vapuhu, her frame, was nirmitam, built of a golden lotus, Kanchana Padma, and therefore it has both the features of gold of the lotus. Mrudu Prakritya. Mrudu means soft or delicate. Prakritya, by your nature. The two chas indicate simultaneity. Simultaneously it was sasaram, strong. It was delicate as well as strong. Simultaneously. In order to show the contrast as well as the simultaneity, he has introduced eva, mrudu eva, sasaram eva, and prakritya mrudu and prakritya sasaram. So by its very nature, it is both very delicate and also very strong. So this explains the paradox in the conduct of Parvati. So as a princess, she used to play with her friends, play with the ball, and if she played that for even a small duration, she used to get tired, extremely delicate as she was, being a princess. And now, in vivid contrast to that, she is taking up the conduct of the sages, and the conduct of the sages is something which is very rigorous, very demanding, and has certain exacting standards. And Parvati did not emulate the conduct of the sages superficially, but rather went deep into the same. So Muninam Charitam Vyagahyata. And the paradox is resolved by an analogy of an unheard of golden lotus, so by which her frame must have been made. The Kanchana portion, the golden portion, shows the metallic frame, and the lotus portion, the lotus aspect, shows its extreme delicacy by nature. And therefore, by nature, she was both soft and hard. So both delicate and strong is what is indicated in this verse. So Klamam Yayau Kanduka Lila Yapi Ya. Ya, the person, that is Parvati, so she began to get tired. Klamam Yayau. So Klama is fatigue. Klamam yayau is from the root ya prapane. So it belongs to the second conjugation, so 2p adadi parasmaipada. The forms in let are yati, yatah, yanti, etc. And in the lit form, the roots are yayau, yayatuhu, yayuhu, yayitha, yayatha, yayathuhu, yaya, yayau, yayiva, yayima. These are the forms of the root in lit lakara. Klamam yayau, she used to get tired, she used to be fatigued, even by kandukalilaya, kandukasya. Leela yields Kanduka Leela. Taya. So this is Strilinga Tritiya Bhakti Ekochana form. Kanduka Leelaya, with a mere play with the ball, she is to get tired. And now, Taya, by that self same Parvati, Muninam Charitam Yagahyata. The practice of the sages, Charitam is either conduct or practice of the sages, was resorted to. Yagahyata is from V plus root Gah. The Paninian Dhatupatha is Gahu Vilodane. And it is in the passive form. The let one form of root gah is, as it is a prathamagana dhatu, atmanepadi, it is gahate, gahete, gahante, etc. And this is the lung form of the karmani. Pratham Purusha Ekvachana form. So, we have the forms as V plus agahyata, agahyetam, agahyanta, etc. So, V plus agahyata yields vyagahyata. In the formation of the forms where there is an upasarga, and especially in the past tense forms like lung and lung and even rilrung, the upasarga is added after the final form is obtained. Therefore, we first have agahyata, for which we add V. So, V plus agahyata yields vyagahyata. So, taya parvatya muninam charitam vyagahyata. Municharita vigahanam sa kritavati ityartha. So, klamam yayau kandukalilayapiya taya muninam charitam vyagahyata. And the paradox is explained by an analogy in the second half of the verse. Dhruvam, surely, certainly. Dandi gives certain indications that show utpreksha by words like manye, shanke, dhruvam, prayaha. Words such as these indicate that what follows is a figment of imagination of the poet. So it is a sambhavana. So it need not be taken as literally true, but as a supposition by the poet in order to make something sound plausible. So he makes a supposition. Dhruvam, surely, vopuhu is neuter prathama vibhakti ekvachana. So the forms are vopuhu, vopushi, vopumshi, etc. Dhruvam Vapuhu, her frame, Kanchana Padma Nirmitam. As this is Naumskalinga Pratama Vibhakti Ekvachana, this whole expression itself as an adjective to that is also Naumskalinga Pratama Vibhakti Ekvachana form. सो हर वपुहु वास कांचन पद्म निर्मितम. सो द डिजोल्यूशन फॉर दिस इज स्लाइटली स्पेशल. इट इज बी टेकन एज कांचनस्य विकारः कांचनम. सो व्हाट इज मेड ऑफ गोल्ड, दिस इज गोल्ड, दिस इज गोल्डन. एंड देन कांचनंच तत् पद्मंच. सो दिस यील्ड्स कांचन पद्मम. तेन कांचन पद्मेन निर्मितम, कांचन पद्म निर्मितम. क्वालिफाइंग वपुः, ध्रुवम वपुः कांचन पद्म निर्मितम प्रकृत्या मृदु. सो वपुः इट्सेल्फ इज क्वालिफाइड बाय द एक्सप्रेशन मृदु एंड ससारम. सो ऑब्वियसली दीस आर आल्सो N11. So mrudu prakritya. So the word prakriti has its synonyms in the Amarakosha as samsiddhi. Samsiddhi prakrite prakriti tvime, and then swarupa swabhava swarupas swarupancha swabhavascha nisargascha. So these are the synonyms given in Amarakosha. So prakritya by nature, her frame was mrudu, her body was soft and delicate, and vapuhu was not only mrudu, vapuhu sasaram apicha, so it was sasara also. The dissolution for sasaram is sarena sahavartate. Or sometimes alternately given as sarena sahitam. So the poet says that her body must have been built of two opposing elements, one extremely delicate and one extremely strong. And as indications of the two, he has taken up the lotus and the gold. So made of these two, she could withstand the rigors of the austerities that she was now taking up, the very austerities of the sages. And the other aspect, namely the softness, is being indicated by her getting tired on account of the play with the ball itself. In the case of some of the very great persons, such contradictory qualities reside in one place. So in the Ramayana of Valmiki, we also find Rama being described as kalagni sadrishaha krodhe kshamaya prithivi samaha. So whether it was regarding his patience or his anger, he was simply unmatched. We shall stop at this verse now, and we shall take up the next verse in the next session. And 5 minutes gap.